Hi, honeys. How's your day going so far? Mine is going fine. Okay, welcome to my monochromatic abstract painting collab with my daughter, Nicole J. Butler. So, after you get through watching me, go on over to her channel and watch her do her abstract painting in monochromatic colors. Okay. I did it yesterday, y'all. This is what I painted, but I thought about it. I said, this is boring. See, I chose the color blue. I got different shades of blue on here, and it's very textured on this canvas board. That's the good thing about acrylic paint. If you don't like it, you can go over it. That's what I'm gonna do. That's what it looked like. I said, that's boring. What is it? It looks nice. It looks like a vortex. So, got my setup over here. This time I'm going to paint. I mean, I'm going to tape over this. See what I'm doing? Yeah. That's what I'm doing. That's the regular masking tape. It'll come off easy. What do I want to do? Oh, I know I'll do this. Looks even. Yeah, I'll do that. I get it taped up, I'll be back. I'm trying not to make this so long. Okay, let me show you what I've done. I taped off this. So it has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 squares. Not so equal, but that's okay. And I'm gonna paint. I'm gonna use this pale blue. I'm using bright blue. I'm using phthalo blue. It starts with a P. P-H-T-H-A-L-O. Phthalo. That's a real dark blue. And I'm using this ultramarine blue. And I probably put some white on here somewhere or use white to lighten up some of the blues. So, since I get 12 squares and 4 different paints, shades of blue, I'm going to use each color 3 times, spaced out. So, I'm going to start with the lightest color so I don't have to rinse out my paintbrush, y'all. And making sure this is pressed down. So it don't seep, but it really don't matter because this is a blue background. And then when I take the tape off after it's good and dry, well, before it gets too dry, you'll see this original color underneath. I think that's going to be a good abstract. What y'all think? Okay. And I got a big paintbrush. I'm not sure if I'm using the 2-inch or the 1.5-inch. I use this one. Don't want to squirt out, so I take the whole top off. I'm and I got my paint and stuff sitting on my ottoman, but I got it covered with a big black garbage bag. And I forgot to put my rug down here, throw rug, so I don't mess up my other rug. Okay, so I got light blue. I want to paint right here. Okay, let's see what I did. That's light blue. So these are going to be geometric shapes. Trying to fix it so y'all can see what I'm actually doing. Okay, I'm going to use this color three times. Lower this tripod. And I'm gonna lower this tripod so y'all can see. Hungry. I am really, really hungry. It's better to start with. Let's see. Y'all to be able to see what I'm doing. Hi, Walter. Mr. Ford.
Hello. How are you?
Blessed. Archie. Blessed. Okay, where did this other light blue go?
Mango. Cheryl Van Gogh.
Cheryl Van Gogh, okay. I want it on there nice and thick. This light looks harsh. I need a thumbnail of me painting. Alright, that's gonna be my thumbnail. I wanna use all this paint. Oh, you know I may mix it with something. Okay. That's what I'll do. I'll mix it. Okay. Now for the other blue. I'm going to use the next lighter shade of blue. It's called bright blue. And these paints are much thinner than the paints in the tube. Come on, finish dripping. I ain't missing out on nothing. Let's see. Come on, quit dripping. It's thin. I like the full body paints. Putting this over here. Now I'm down too low, which y'all can't see that, but y'all will see the finished product. 8 minutes already. Okay, now I'm gonna use this two more times. Don't do this up here. This will certainly be more interesting than what I started out with, in my opinion. Okay, now one more. Anybody can paint. Just slap some colors on a board in the colors of your house, and you got artwork. What do you think these famous painters be doing? Artists. You go to the nice art museums, and you be looking at stuff and wonder, what were they thinking? What is that? And people paying thousands of dollars for stuff like that. So they can do it, I can do it. Okay, I'm gonna use another color. Okay, there's two colors on here. Now, two dark colors. Use the ultramarine blue and it's dark and it's thick like I like it. See that? It's thick. I like that. You know what? I want to mix the other colors in it. No. I'll probably put some splatters in here to make it more interesting. It certainly is monochromatic. I want some texture. I like the paintings that, I mean, you can feel. Even though I don't want nobody feeling on what I painted, but I want you to be able to see the texture. I had put up the other video and scheduled it for Wednesday at 10 o'clock. Okay, I need one more square of this color. Right here. I'm gonna have to let this dry almost completely. I want it to still be kind of wet when I take the tape off, because I don't want the tape to dry stuck to here. I mean, I don't want the paint to dry and make this tape stick. I have my artwork all over my house, y'all. And some I didn't show y'all. I got some on shelves. And I'll never think about it when I'm showing people my stuff. And this last color is really dark. Phthalo blue. You know what? I'm gonna mix it with this other paint I got on here. It looks almost black. Well, like a navy blue. Show you. Right there, it looks, you can tell it's blue. I think I'm gonna mix all these other colors with it, so it will no longer be phthalo blue. I'm gonna put some white in it. I don't want it to be close to nothing else. I want it to be its own color. Okay, it's different. If I had a real canvas, you know, the thick canvas, I would be painting the sides also, but I ain't worried about this. I signed it and everything down in this corner. I signed it SIS Assist IVD, Sister Ford. IV is number 4 in Roman numerals. And I put the D there for D, Ford. This phase of it, I ain't gonna pick it up, but y'all can see. So I'm gonna let this dry. Looks like it needs some more something. I'm gonna use my fan brush. Here I go, big fan brush. I want to do something to it. some light blue dots, splatters. I'll be back. 18 minutes. Okay, this is how it looks. I'm getting ready to take the tape off. I taped this to the back of here. Now I'm peeling it. Okay, I got it. Let's see. I'll tape this too. Why did I do? Ooh, I scraped it with my fingernails. I can't stand that sound. Tear that. Because it's taped to the back. And you're gonna see my original paint underneath. I'm gonna scrape that no more. Can't stand that feeling and that sound. Okay, I left an edge loose. This edge loose. Ooh, I'm gonna paint on my hand. Ew. And I got a little piece back here. Fill it. And okay. Yeah, I like this. This is much more interesting than what I had, in my opinion. That's abstract, y'all. You know, right or wrong way to hang it. I think I'm going to put a gloss over the whole thing once it's fully dry, and I will be done. I have to sign it down here in this light spot. So let me take it off. This is my abstract, monochromatic abstract painting. Now I'm happy with it. But I am going to varnish it to make it shine. I'm going to show you what I'm going to use. This is what I'm going to use. I wish I had used it. Mixed some in this paint. Some of the paint is matte. Like the thinner paints I was using, that's matte color. And I could have mixed this with the paint to make it shiny. So, this is called Liquitex Gloss Medium and Varnish. So you get this from Walmart or Amazon. Okay. I want to thank you all for watching. Give me a thumbs up. Leave a nice comment and subscribe to my channel. And you all have a very blessed rest of the evening. I mean, it's 1:35. Sunday afternoon. Now I got to find something to eat. Bye. Be blessed.